Hi everyone, welcome to our program Doctor. I am Dr. Adeline and today my topic is immunity. Before we discuss about what is infection and what is disease, we should know what is immunity. How our body shows defense mechanism against various diseases and infections. And by the definition, immunity is the resistance offered by the host to particular pathogenic organisms and their toxic products.
Organs of the immune system. Major organs: bone marrow, thymus gland, spleen and lymph nodes. Other organs of the immune system: adenoids and tonsils. Cells of the immune system: T cells, natural killer cells also called as NK cells, B cells, granulocytes, macrophages and dendritic cells.
So here again you have to know what is pathogen, what is antigen, what is antibody, and what is resistance, what is susceptibility, etc. So what is antigen? Antigen is any substance which when introduced parenterally into our body, able to stimulate the production of the antibodies and which can react with the antibodies specifically and in an observable manner and produce antigen-antibody reactions. That is the definition of antigen. And these antigens may be microorganisms like bacteria, virus, fungus, protozoa, helminths and yeast, etc. Or maybe chemicals or maybe pollens. Here you have to remember the word parenteral. Parenteral means outside the intestinal tract. Next, coming to the antibody. What is antibody? Antibody is also called as immunoglobulin, which is a Y-shaped glycoprotein produced by the antigenic stimulus, and it can react with the particular antigen and produce antigen-antibody reactions. That is called antibody. And mainly antibodies are produced by the plasma cells. In antibodies, mainly there are five types: immunoglobulin G, immunoglobulin A, immunoglobulin M, immunoglobulin E and immunoglobulin D. And immunologically, immunity is two types: B cell immunity and T cell immunity. Both plays very important role in our defense mechanism.
Pathogen is a microorganism when they enter into our body able to produce infection or disease. Infection is an invasion and multiplication of pathogenic microorganisms in our body. They may produce subsequent tissue injury or damage. Disease is a pathological condition of a part, organ, or system of an organism resulting from various causes such as infection, genetic defect, environmental stress, characterized by identifiable group of signs and symptoms.
Coming to the resistance, what is resistance? It is a power to remain unharmed or unaffected by the microorganism. What is susceptibility? It is a prone or being affected by the microorganisms, so they may cause infections or diseases. Next, coming to our topic, immunity. In immunity, again, there are two types: innate immunity, acquired immunity. Innate immunity also called as native immunity, and acquired immunity also called as adaptive immunity. Innate immunity is a resistance to infections which an individual possesses by birth. So it is not affected by prior contact with microorganisms or immunization. And in innate immunity, again, two types: non-specific and specific. Again, in non-specific, specific, innate immunity, we can see three types: species immunity, racial immunity, and individual immunity. First one is species innate immunity. For example, humans are not affected by plant pathogens and animal pathogens. That is called species immunity. Next one is racial immunity. Within the species, there are different races, right? So again, different races may show differences in the susceptibility to infections. For example, African races are more susceptible to tuberculosis than whites. Next one is individual immunity. The differences in innate immunity exhibited by the different individuals within the race is called as individual immunity. For example, homozygous twins exhibit similar degrees of resistance to Lepromatous leprosy and tuberculosis. That means individually they possess immunity. That is called individual immunity. Next, coming to the what are the important factors which can influence the innate immunity. First one is age. Very young and very old people are highly susceptible to infections or diseases. The reason is in young people there is a underdevelopment of the immune system, and in old people there is a waning of immune system. And second factor is hormonal influences. The persons who are suffering with endocrinal disorders, for example diabetes mellitus, hypothyroidism and adrenal dysfunction, etc., they are highly susceptible to various infections because of the abnormalities in their hormones. Next, third important point is nutrition. Malnutrition or poor nutrition can lead to infections. And I'm not going to go in details about mechanism and all because it's a larger subject. But I want to emphasize the important points that you should understand as far as the immune system is concerned. Next, coming to the acquired immunity or adaptive immunity. By the definition, acquired immunity means the resistance that an individual acquires during lifetime is known as acquired immunity. In this, again, two types: active acquired immunity, passive acquired immunity. Active acquired immunity means the resistance developed by an individual as a result of antigenic stimulus. So in this case, there is an active involvement of the person's immune apparatus. For example, if any pathogen enters into our body, this pathogen can stimulate the production of the antibodies. So that is the active acquired immunity. And in active acquired immunity, again, there are two types: natural and artificial. First one is natural active immunity. Here the immunity developed by infection by microorganisms. And this type of immunity is usually long lasting. For example, poliomyelitis and measles. But in some viral infections, the immunity is short-lived. For example, common cold, influenza, etc. And second one is artificial active acquired immunity. And here the resistance induced by the vaccines. And in the coming episode, I want to talk details about vaccines and immunization schedule and all. And second one is passive acquired immunity. Here, the resistance transmitted passively to the recipient in a ready-made form. Here, host immune system plays no role. That means there is no antigenic stimulus. So we are giving antibodies in ready-made form. That is called as passive acquired immunity. And in passive acquired immunity, again there are two types, natural and artificial. First one is natural passive acquired immunity. Here the resistance passively transferred from mother to baby. And second one is artificial passive acquired immunity. Here the resistance passively transferred to the recipient by the administration of the antibodies. And I hope this brief information regarding immunity helps you to understand the importance of the immune system in our body. And I hope you enjoyed this program. Thanks for watching. And we will meet in the next episode with important topic, vaccines. Till then, take care and bye.